I thought you'd gone to work.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well?
Well, what?
Oh, come on, Marty. Where have you been all night?
Stayed with some mates from school.
Which mates?
Oh, you don't know them.
Why did you stay?
Oh, hell, Mum, we had a bit of a party, that's all. When I noticed the time, it was so late, I decided not to ring you.
And since when would we have objected to you waking us up?
Okay, it wasn't only that. If I'd told the others I'd had to check in with me parents, would have made me look like a kid.
Well, that's what you are, a kid.
No, I'm not, Dad.
What happened last night?
Nothing happened, Mum.
You've never lied to us, Marty. Don't start now.
Look, stop treating me like one of your crooners, will you? That's the trouble with you two, you know that? You're both so used to locking up people in their cells, you think you can do that to me too? Well, I come and go as I please, okay?
Now, hold on. We're not finished yet.
Dad, I've done nothing wrong. Now, either you believe me or you don't. It's up to you.
We haven't time to talk now. Let's sit down quietly tonight, eh?
You sure I can spare the time?
What do you mean by that?
Forget it. I'm late for school.
Well, your breakfast ready?
I'm not hungry, Mum.
Oh, sorry, we're late, Marty.
So what's new?
Now, come on, son. It's not our fault if we're hell of at work.
Of course not. Well, I'm running late now.
But we were going to have a chat.
Yeah. Well, that'll keep.
No, it won't keep. Anyway, where are you off to?
Going to see a friend.
Or someone we know?
No. When you can both spare the time, I'd like to bring her home.
Her?
Look, you might as well know. I'd like to move out and live with her. And that's what I wanted to talk to you about. Hello? Hi. No, I was just leaving. Yeah. Bye. See you tomorrow, eh?
You can't be serious. Hey, Marty, your dad realizes he hasn't been spending a lot of time with you lately, but he really has been awfully busy. We both get off at 4. How about we jump in the car and go down to Frankston, have a swim, talk things over then?
Dad's night for lectures.
He said he'd cancel them.
Honest.
Honest.
Okay, then. I'll see you home at 4. The garden looks a mess.
Yeah. Mum would be upset if she could see it now.
You call her Mum? You know, the way you and Dad talk, anyone would think these prisoners were a family.
Mum? Dad? Anybody home?
Can I speak to Bill Jackson? What about Mrs. Jackson? So they're there.
Meg, for heaven's sake.
Where have you been?
What's it to you?
Don't you dare speak to me like that, young man. You're getting too big for your boots.
Yeah, well, isn't it about time you stopped treating me like a child?
What are you if you're not a child?
I'm nearly 17, for God's sake.
Marty, there was a riot at the prison today. Your father got stabbed by one of the girls. He died about an hour ago, Marty. Sorry.
Trying to avoid me?
No.
Well, I waited for you during the morning break. Marty, you did talk to your parents about leaving home, didn't you?
No.
Well, why not?
I couldn't. I don't know, my father's dead. One of the prisoners stabbed him. While we were discussing getting a flat together, he was dying.
Oh, Marty, how awful. Oh, I don't know what to say. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, I suppose I should have told you earlier. I couldn't. I didn't even want to come into school today. I wanted to stay home with Mum.
Well, why didn't you?
She wouldn't let me. She didn't even want to talk to me. She just cut herself off.
Yeah, that's probably the shock. Look, do you think it would help any if I came home with you this afternoon and spoke to her?
I doubt it.
Well, we could try.
Yeah, I suppose.
What's going on here? Shouldn't you be in class, Jackson? I'll have to have a word with your parents if this keeps up.
Oh, but sir!
Look, it's all right, Donna.
Why didn't you tell him?
Look, everybody will know soon enough.
They found out who stabbed your father. Well, don't you want to know who did it?
I wouldn't know her. The name wouldn't mean anything to me. It was just one of the prisoners.
Yes, they're all the same to you.